Now, PPE is a term many of us hadn't heard of months ago, but now, well, it's a key part of the fight against coronavirus. Last month, we brought you the story of a team from the University of Southampton who'd worked round the clock to develop a respirator hood to protect hospital staff. The kit is now being used on COVID wards at the city's main hospital. Tom Hepworth has found out more.
They called it the Spitfire Project, a local solution to a pressing national crisis. Within the space of just 5 weeks, an idea has become reality. Normally, INDO in Southampton makes street lights. They're now a shining example of how businesses, universities and hospitals are working together in a new world.
We've had a lot of inquiries, mainly from the trusts in the area predominantly, as Southampton have obviously shared the information about this, but the plan is to offer this to the NHS, you know, nationwide.
The first PERSO hoods are already being used on COVID wards at Southampton General. They're replacing surgical masks but haven't yet been cleared for use in the highest risk areas. And this is how the PERSO works. Now, this isn't one that goes onto the wards. This is a demonstrator only, but it works the same. A fan draws air through a HEPA filter in this unit, which removes 99.95% of particulates, including the virus. Then it pumps all the air up through this hose at 170 litres a minute, and it comes, basically fills the hood with cool air. And it does feel pretty cool in here, although it does sound like you're in a room with a hairdryer on the lowest setting. And what's more, it is completely reusable. You can decontaminate this and use it again. And because they're reusable, it means in future the hospital wouldn't be as reliant on supplies of disposable PPE when there's a global shortage. This is made 2.5 miles down the road.
It's made a huge difference because, for example, when one of the first prototypes failed its test, I just collected some test solution from the hospital. I drove across the university. I used it. Similarly, the university were driving at 2 o'clock in the morning to deliver their prototype to the industry collaborators so they could start working on it. So the locality has really helped accelerate this through, and everyone's willingness to work together to the same goal.
My name's Jackie, and I'm here to introduce the PERSO respirator.
After prototypes were put through their paces last month, training is now well underway. The Trust will be the first in the country to start widely using this equipment. So, what's the verdict among those who are getting used to them?
Actually, you do feel a bit more protected than just a surgical mask. Patients are a lot happier as well because they actually get to see your face. Whereas before, with a mask, you could be smiling at a patient and they don't even know that you're smiling or any facial expression, so they're a lot happier as well.
It takes a little bit of kind of getting used to after a few weeks of just wearing the surgical masks. It's a bit of a kind of inconvenience when we're having to take it off.
It's so hot up here, the doors are all shut. You know, there's no fans that are allowed to be used, so it's quite nice to feel quite cool.
INDO can make around 10,000 hoods a week. It's applied for a government grant from the Innovate UK COVID Support Fund, and if it's successful in May, it could make 50,000 and meet an urgent national demand. Tom Hepworth, BBC South Today,